We begin in India, where life-saving oxygen supplies are running out.
देखिए ऑक्सीजन की किल्लत का अगर किसी ने पॉलिटिकल रोना धोना है तो मैं इसको रोक नहीं सकता, परंतु मेरे पास सटीक आंकड़े हैं। डिमांड सप्लाई का गैप बहुत नैरो हुआ है मगर कमी नहीं। एक दो दिन में भी सभी जगह पर्याप्त मात्रा में रिजर्व स्टॉक भी हो जाए।
50 people died in the capital after their oxygen supply ran out.
My husband died just for the lack of oxygen. They've killed him. How can over 20 people die like that at the same time?
And we can understand if I lose somebody of mine, then naturally you feel bad.
Please come see my mother, this man pleads, but it's too late for her. This man says his wife couldn't breathe, but the hospital didn't have any oxygen to spare. By morning, she was dead.
If we cannot give them oxygen even, what is the situation? The patient comes to the patient will die. Patient will die.
Without oxygen.
Do you know how a human being dies without oxygen? Have you seen a fish out of water? This is unimaginable.
They are all human beings. They were my patients. They were my responsibility. They came on faith of Dr. Baruja and Jaipur Golden Hospital. But what Dr. Baruja doesn't have is oxygen in his hand. And where we failed, the only element which was to be contributed by the government, oxygen. That's the one factor which failed.
And this is a never-ending thing. It happens every day. This today is one of the worst days. And I'm really sorry, but it's overwhelming and it's very depressing and it's very... I'm sorry I cannot go on, but I just want to highlight it's a sad state of affairs. I'm sorry.
First of all, I think it's too much of an anxiety for healthcare workers to live from one oxygen cylinder to another oxygen cylinder. We can't just live like that. We can't live under so much of pressure because we are at the front line and we need oxygen.
Yeah,
of course.
Let me just give you some statistics, hard statistics, and I think it is important for everyone to know that oxygen, what you are trying, she is trying to convey that there is a shortage of oxygen. Yes, it may have created some shortage for a couple of days, but I'm sure that going forward, all these issues are being addressed and now situation is in control.
And I would say that I lost three patients yesterday and all the hospital have lost five patients.
Due to lack of oxygen.
So yesterday, the chief minister of the largest state in India, where the maximum number of cases are being reported, has said that anybody who tweets about lack of oxygen in the state, their properties will be confiscated.
No. This is going to peak. When it will peak, we will have four times of patient now at that time. We barely need oxygen. Otherwise, we cannot save patients.
All these videos which you are trying to show to the world will become only history because everybody is getting the kind of attention and the government under the leadership of the Honorable Prime Minister is reviewing the situation on a dynamic basis and all the assistance which needed to be given to the citizen of this great country are being given to the country.
Meanwhile, the Indian government has asked Twitter to take down dozens of tweets, including some by local lawmakers that were critical of India's handling of the outbreak.
And this is not the time in which we can raise our hands and say that it's, you know, we managed to, you know, break over the pandemic. We've not managed. It's just the beginning. And if the attitude of the government remains as such, in which they say that, you know, we've done everything for the public, that's not enough. You have to do more. You have to do better.
Such experience is what you have the what you are trying to showcase about the country in a very poor light is something which should not be experienced by the citizen of this great country.
Our hospitals are already overwhelmed, so there is no more beds available, there is no more oxygen points available. I have even seen the oxygen given to 10 patients from a single oxygen point. So it is becoming very difficult, very traumatic and very exhaustive.
And this is not something we are enjoying and we are not able to help people now.
Hospital beds, ventilators and even medicines have run short.
Threatening to turn what's already a public health crisis into catastrophe.
No beds or room inside the hospital. Patients are left outside in an anxious wait for help.
Nothing will happen. Nothing will happen. Nothing will happen.
Families are getting increasingly desperate.
Patients continue to arrive at hospitals struggling to breathe, needing urgent treatment. But the health system is close to collapse.
The picture which you have just shown, it's not like every single hospital you have the similar kind of picture. This must be one of those pictures where, or the video which you have just shown, could be some experience of some people, but that's the initial stage. Government has definitely working day and night and to ensure that all the patients which needs hospitalization must get the hospital, a bed in the hospital, and they also get all the assistance what they need in the hospital.
I don't know if BJP's ruling party lives in the same country as the rest of us at this point.
And unfortunately, Sonal, nobody is thinking, I am getting 500 calls a day. Dr. Sahab, hum kahan jayenge? Where will we go? People are on the roadside, outside the casualty.
Now that we have reached a threshold as far as oxygen and remdesivir is present, it means that a lot of people are going to be denied hospital bed, they're going to be denied oxygen, and those who are critical are not going to get the kind of treatment that they want.
What can you do now? He needs to go to a hospital.
Hospital, no more beds. No more beds in hospital.
This is every family's fight now, but too many are taking on this virus with nothing to fight it with. The whole country's been destroyed, he says. The whole country's destroyed.
The Indian government had itself declared it had beaten the coronavirus in February.
And the health minister said India was in the end game of the pandemic.
But then the Prime Minister's National Scientific Task Force did not meet all through February and March.
Health experts say the country became complacent as the government lifted restrictions that allowed big social gatherings and political rallies.
And I think all these led to a sense of fearlessness in people that maybe COVID was just a fluke. It's over. That's the message that people got. And I think that's the main reason for a huge surge this time. And it's beyond our control.
The situation today is so bad. I can't imagine what will happen in the coming days.
So what will happen in the coming weeks? So I'm really afraid this time that it has gone out of control.
And I've never seen this kind of a crisis situation, and I hope that nobody else sees it.
We are in the midst of one of the most grievous challenges our country has faced since the partition.
Yeah. बीमारी हो सकता घातक हो लेकिन इससे भी ज्यादा घातक है सिस्टम जिन्होंने हमें डरा दिया.
Even if now some active interventions was not done, then it will result into the worst crisis of the century.